Provision of health and food are the basic necessities of all human beings. And number of organizations and people are involved in this research. And though both are very complex system to deal with, but I think that few of the things we can deal together, like we can deal diabetes and poverty together. So what's all around the world, almost more than 422 million people are deficient of insulin, and they have a problem of diabetes. And their number is expected to be increased in next 22 years, and it will be almost 640 million. And if you will look, focus more in detail, you can see that in these countries, like in Southeast Asia, Africa, Middle East, and South America, you can find that their number will be almost doubled. And these countries also have a problem of food insecurity. So these countries may have a more problem of this disease, and there will be imbalanced development among the different cultures. So what we can do? So the one thing which I forgot to describe is that they have very low income as well. If they have just $4 income per day, and if they will be given a chance to purchase food or medicine, definitely they will go for food because it's their whole family dependency, and they will not purchase food. So what we can do as a scientist, we can, though this is already producing insulin within the bacteria, so we can insert this gene within the wheat or any other grain crop. And if we are lucky enough, we can breed these lines and we can make the stable lines. And if we are lucky to harvest the grains which are having a high amount of insulin, we can test these grains. Like we can detect in those mice which are deficient of insulin, and we can check their blood samples, whether they have this gene or whether this gene is working within their body or not. And secondly, we can also test through some direct detection, like we can grind the grains in the form of powder, and we can detect whether through molecular means that whether this gene is present or not. And similarly, we can detect through some biochemical or chemical detection, and we can also check the quality parameters of the grains as well. So in this way, we can kill two birds with one stone. So this is all about. Thank you.